Coral is formed by millions of tiny carnivorous animals called polyps. Each polyp builds a case of limestone around itself, using calcium from the water to form the skeletons of coral. The alga lives symbiotically inside the tissues of the skeleton and photosynthesizes energy from sunlight to provide nutrients for the polyp. Multiple skeletons are cemented together with a form of calcium carbonate called aragonite to create the renowned vivid coral reef. However, factors including global warming can increase water temperatures, sea levels, and acidity in the ocean. The coral will gradually eliminate the algae because it takes up too much energy to support, leaving behind a bare skeleton. The coral can survive like this for a couple of days and regenerate. However, if sea conditions continue, they'll most likely die. This is called coral bleaching. The Great Barrier Reef, located on the coastline of Queensland, covers an area of 348,000 square kilometres of coral and marine life. Coral reefs are an integral part of the ocean, providing protection and shelter for many species of fish, controls the amount of carbon dioxide in the water, in the limestone shell, and living up to their name, they create a barrier that protects coasts from strong currents by slowing down the water before it gets to the shore. Australian scientists have proposed to cover the endangered coral reefs and the Great Barrier Reef with a shade cloth to protect them against further damage from global warming by essentially blocking out the sun just like an ordinary shade cell. To cover an area of 348,000 square kilometres with one sheet of plastic covering would seem ridiculously impossible. It is essential for the algae and coral polyp to have access to sunlight to photosynthesize and craft the skeletons for the stunning reef. Marine life will suffer as well if a shade cloth blocks out the sunlight. Tropical fish and sea creatures that live in coral reefs need oxygen and sunlight to survive. Their health will diminish and they will ultimately have to migrate to other areas that provide them with their vital needs. The World Heritage listed Great Barrier Reef is a major contributor for the tourism industry and generated over $4,288,000,000 in 2003. There are a variety of tourism operations including snorkeling, scuba diving, helicopter tours and cruise ships, just to name a few. There are approximately 820 operators managing the marine park. If the shade cloth plan is ineffective, then many would lose their jobs and the popularity of Australia would decline. With a shade cloth covering and preserving this unique undersea garden, society would soon lose interest of observing jaw-dropping reefs that could build behind a large cloth. The cost of building a shade cloth to cover 348,000 km² wouldn't be very economical. Consider the cost of shade cells on land that cost $2,800 for every 30 m². Keeping true to the aim of covering the whole reef, it would add up to a total of $300 billion. If this scheme were to fail, then Australia would have a great downfall in their economy and be in severe debt. Jobs would be lost and taxes would rise to fill the hole in the economy. However, the increasing temperature stress is said to be a main cause of a decline in the aragonite in the seawater, which prevents coral to deposit calcium carbonate necessary to form coral reefs. If the shade cloths are effective in slightly decreasing the temperature under the sea by reflecting sunlight, the corals may begin to rejuvenate and restore calcification. If this plan is effective, then it would be highly beneficial for Australia's popularity, increasing the tourism rates, thus increasing the popularity and the economy of Australia. The coral reefs are increasingly depleting all over the world, with more than 50% of coral reefs bleached and 5% permanently damaged by global warming. The red dots indicate severe coral bleaching in 2006. There are 9 reef areas in Jamaica. Since 1988, Jamaica has been growing coral and restoring their coral reefs with the use of artificial reefs. This artificial reef, developed by architect W. Hilbert, uses electrolysis of seawater to precipitate calcium and magnesium minerals to grow a crystalline coating over iron and steel structures. The minerals that are used are very similar to the limestone in coral reefs. Corals have grown at exceptional rates, even in poor water quality. Also, a complete assemblage of marine life has migrated to these reefs. These reefs are uniquely suited for not only restoring coral reefs, However, they protect shorelines, maintain biodiversity, and adapt to the rising sea levels. Coral Reef Watch is an organization that uses continuous satellite data to alert managers and scientists around the world of the risk of coral bleaching. A recent development monitors the sea surface temperature forecast to predict a coral bleaching 3 months in advance. In conclusion, covering the Great Barrier Reef with a large cloth may temporarily decrease heat stress on the coral reefs. In the long run, covering the reef will only cause more damage. It will enclose the sunlight and fresh water needed to create coral pulp, also suffocating the species of marine life living in coral reefs, forcing them to migrate elsewhere. Coral reefs are the ocean's underwater forests. They regulate carbon dioxide levels and provide a habitat for countless biodiversity in the sea. If these reefs become extinct, not only will humanity lose one of the most fascinating wonders on the planet, however, many species of fish and sea creatures that are dependent on these coral reefs will also vanish. It is critical that we do everything possible to sustain these beautiful reefs for many generations to come.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you, what more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea.